Summer's Eve show. Which means I now have an excuse to act like a total douche. Usually I just come up here and act like a total douche.
Yeah.
Now I have a reason that it's part of the theme. Yeah, there's that legitimate rape. It's so ridiculous to say legitimate rape. I can't physically get my mouth to say that shit. It's just stupid, right? Legitimate rape. I swear, I want him to send that Todd Akin guy to prison so we can see if he gets pregnant when he's legitimately raped.
Yep.
But, I started looking into it this week, and I found out that in 31, and we only got 50 states, in 31 of our damn states, the rapist, if the lady gets pregnant and has a child, rapist can get visitation and sometimes custody rights.
Jeez.
How fucked up of a mother you gotta be that the rapist gets custody rights? I'm sorry, that's just weird. And if he's getting visitations, like, isn't that going to make the, you know, hey, mommy, how did you and daddy meet? Isn't that going to make that awkward? Well, I'm running through the parking lot and I dropped my keys. Your daddy's just not romantic. It's weird, man. It's not wrong. This is our country, man. It's the fuck we live in. What the hell is wrong with this place? You know, I keep thinking that if we're going to, you know, there's all these people in America that want us to be like a religious, you know, Christian nation and all this. Can we please choose the Christianity where it's like Jesus telling everybody to take care of one another and love each other, as opposed to this, hey, you aren't like me, I'm going to shoot you, Christianity? I don't know. It's shit I think about. And you saw Prince Harry was in, apparently what happens in Vegas doesn't always stay in Vegas. But Prince Harry, man, he was in the room playing strip billiards. I would say strip pool, but that's skinny dipping. That's different. He's playing strip billiards with these girls. They're like, oh, you're a prince. You shouldn't do that. Do you realize there are, I can't even tell you how many guys that are probably in Vegas right now lying about being a prince just to get girls to come play strip billiards. Shouldn't do that. It's practically required. If I was a prince, I'd just walk up to him and be like, I'm a prince. Lose your clothes. Can't do that shit when you look like me, you know, fuck. If I was a prince, then I could look like me and do that shit. In this country, we've got one prince that can do that shit. He's like 3 feet tall and comes from Minnesota. 3 feet of fucking dynamite, that dude. He is cool. I don't care. I'm not like the biggest Prince fan, but you can't deny that dude's fucking cool. You know? Anybody that can turn Appalachia into a crackhead's got to do that shit. What's her name? Apollonia. That sounds like a deli sandwich. That ain't even right, man. I got an Apollonia and, you know, fermented. I can't even think of a cheese off the top of my head that would. What would you put on Apollonia?
Gouda.
Gouda. An Apollonia and Gouda sandwich. Yikes. Sounds good. But if you're going to do that, they got to start coming out with, like, you know, pussy flavored popcorn and shit like that, too. There should be, you know, come on, every guy loves the taste of pussy. Not every guy, but any sensible straight guy loves the taste of pussy, let me tell you. If they had pussy flavored products, we'd be buying them. Guarantee if Jack in the Box is like, we got the pussy chicken sandwich, come on, get it. You'd be like, give me 14 of them. 3D. No? No. What are you going to do with the rest of them? Hello. And, God, what else? I knew a girl in high school that had 32 D's. She's a horrible student. It's just bad. Hey, did I do my creationist shit last week?
No.
With all due respect to Jeff Foxworthy, there's a lot of creationists in this country. And I realize, you know, if you believe that Adam and Eve got booted out of the Garden of Eden only to be chased by a T-Rex, you might be a creationist. If you think that fucking Noah's Ark is on the top of, what is it, Mount Everest, or the fuck mountain it is, you might be a creationist. You know what mountain it is. What mountain? It ain't mountain.
Ararat.
And I knew it wasn't Everest. It just sounds like Everest. If you live alone and you got more than 3 dozen Bibles, you're probably a creationist. I don't know. Just trying those out. God. What else did I have? Something else. How much? I got one more minute?
No.
He's just adjusting the glasses, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to be up here for another hour. Oh, now he's cutting me short. Look at this shit.
No, no.
Fuck that, man. You ain't up there for all that time. What else I got, man? Did my atheist stuff. Oh, yeah, you hear Rush Limbaugh? This was weird. Rush Limbaugh said that Obama was conjuring up a hurricane to send to Florida. He actually said that shit on the radio. Like he thinks Obama called up Kenya and said, everybody just start... send that shit over there. Fuck, man. Even that Todd Akin guy had some shit about global warming where he's like, yeah, well, Obama wants to impose all this stuff, so he's making global warming happen. It's like, dude, do you realize how weather works? Fucking people, man. It's like everybody in their party is Sarah Palin. It doesn't matter. There's nobody... There's, like, no level above that. Even, I hate to say this, Bill Maher pointed out that Paul Ryan, who's supposed to be, like, the superstar of the party, agrees with everything Palin says. They're all fucking idiots, man. Why are we doing this shit? And speaking of something that I thought was stupid, did you hear about that teacher? I don't think this part was stupid, but there's a teacher that was having, like, group sex with her students. The dumb part is they want to give her jail time.
Aww.
You make that woman homeroom. No guy is ever going to miss school. You just don't know how the day might turn out. Just the hint of possible sex would have had me showing up at school. The fact that there was girls that wouldn't fuck me made me show up at school, all right? Just because you never know. That's the one thing with guys, we're delusional about that, right? We can be completely outclassed and we're like, but you never know. When I was a kid, I was like that. I'd be like 12, trying to chase like a 16-year-old. And she's just like, please, you stop. And I'm like, no, but you never know. I got a hard-on last year. I know I can do it again. I meant when I was a kid, not now. I got out of time now. Anytime Vaseline pops out, just, whoop, there it goes. Look at that. That's terrible. Don't masturbate with Vaseline, especially if you smoke weed. You may inadvertently light your dick on fire. It is hard to keep the noise down while you're trying to put out a dick fire in the other room. Let me tell you. Like, fucking shit. I've never put out a dick fire. I just imagine that's what you would do. I did the last thing, and this is just a true story thing. When I was a kid, I used to like, if you passed out around me and my friends, just forget it. It was over. And so this dude passed out around us. And we took and put a huge pile of, like, shaving cream on his crotch and took, like, a ladle and scooped out a little, like, a dome thing and put, lighter fluid in there and lit a little fire. And said, hey, dude, fire! He woke up and punched himself in the balls. I'm sorry, that should just like, hang the fuck out of me.